Alright, as though one street fight wasn't enough for Merrick, he's got...
On the winner end from Toledo, Ohio.
As though one street fight weren't enough for Merrick, he's got to take on Brady in another street fight here as part of the punishment for Team Mitchell, but Brady has got to be energized by that cruiserweight title defense Trav just put on. Let's see if Brady can put on the same sort of performance and maybe get Team Mitch out another win. What's to note here, though, is that Brady got fired from Taco Bell. He is now looking for another second job to support his wrestling. Because of it, the case of the oppressor is considered proprietary information for Taco Bell. He can no longer use that move, which was his killer finisher move. He had to develop a new one this week. Let's see if that new finisher stands the test against one of the toughest competitors, the toughest new competitors that the MMWF has, Merrick Duraff. Lost the street fight against his brother Neff, the CEO. Now sort of coming to the ring, he knows he's coming off a couple of losses here, a couple of tough losses, and he's coming into a match against a very energized Brady Pope. Brady's got to be excited after seeing that win. That's got to be a big huge help for them. Oh, right. Controller. Merrick Duraff. Definitely sets the ring on fire. He definitely sets the show on fire. He is exciting to watch. But does he have what it takes to maybe break this string of losses he's got and take a huge win over Brady Pope in this street fight? Of course, no disqualification here. This is a street fight. We've got some weapons placed about the ring. Let's see who's going to take the win here. Brady starting with the attack here. Taking down Merrick. Merrick putting Brady in the turnbuckle, however. And then with that body attack, it looks like. With the kick to the face, I don't know if Brady has what it takes to beat down Merrick. Although Brady is a more seasoned fighter, Merrick has more surprises just like that. And Merrick has taken down Brady with almost an MMA-style attack here. Series of kicks, series of punches, kneeing him in the head, putting Brady in the turnbuckle now, and a flip kick there. And another series of kicks, and Brady, I don't think, has what it takes. He cannot keep up with Merrick. Merrick Duraff has already taken down Brady and is keeping him down. No need for weapons here. Here comes the Giga Onslaught. And Merrick, just with a series of strikes, just striking attack after striking attack, and now the Giga Onslaught. Here's the pin. One, two. Two count there. Brady managing to kick out. and he gets up to a kick in the face. Barrett now putting him up on the shoulders. Let's see if Brady can reverse out of it. Brady getting thrown unceremoniously out of the ring. Barrett coming down, almost landing on his head. But Brady has a guitar now, and uses that to his advantage. He breaks that over Merrick's head. And now it looks like the tag championship belt is laying outside the ring as well. And Merrick may be picking that up. Nope, he's going to get a guitar of his own. But Brady makes him whiff. He dodges out of the way, and he's going to ringside to get a table. Maybe to shield the guitar attacks? I don't know. Well, it wasn't very effective as Merrick was able to use the guitar to slam the table right into Brady's face. And now he's got a sledgehammer, and we could be finishing this match with Brady going out on a stretcher. Oof! Taking a sledgehammer to the gut. Sledgehammer just going 100% into Brady's back, and now into the gut again. Oh, that is painful to watch, and Brady is feeling it. Brady somehow managing to get up, but he's probably going, oh, he's going for the sledgehammer, he's got it! Coming at Merrick, and I think he hit Merrick so hard in return that he broke the sledgehammer. Now, I'm not entirely sure what Brady and Merrick are doing here, but Brady finally fending him off with a punch. Clubbing Merrick in the head with that elbow there. Brady finally getting some offense going here. Oof, nice double axe handle. Putting Merrick in the turnbuckle. The low drop kicks in the torso there. Brady could be going for another weapon here. Going once again for his tag championship belt, which had been moved back under the ring. And putting it right in Merrick's face. I think wanted Merrick to see what he's never going to get, maybe. But, ooh, another shot to the face with a title belt. And that is not the way that Merrick wanted to get the title. Once again, taking it in the face. And Brady is using his title belt as a very, very powerful weapon here. Just taking it to Merrick. And Merrick hasn't been able to recover from that. And finally, Brady, PKO! PKO! Oh my God! Brady taking Merrick down. Here's the pin! 1, 2, 3! What? Brady recovering from just that endless onslaught of strikes and a giga onslaught using the belt, proving exactly why he's here, and now Team Bitch Out has 2 in a row! And they have proven why they are the tag team champions. Could this continue? If Team Bitch Out uses these 2 wins to their advantage, really, they could defend their tag team titles against the world champion. Oh, man. We have 2 more matches to go tonight here on Thursday Night Magic, rather. I'm sorry. Stay tuned.